Good evening and welcome parents, siblings, families, and friends to our 2015 graduation ceremony. Buenas tardes y bienvenidos, padres y familiares, a esta ceremonia de graduación del año 2015. My name is Darsha Guayad, and I'm the principal at PSJA College Career and Technology Early College High School. First of all, I would like to take this time to congratulate everyone on this special occasion. There are so many people that have labored hard just to see you, our graduates, here on this very night. Mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, and friends, thank you for your support and congratulations to you as well. Madres, padres, y hermanos, amigos, y gracias por su apoyo y felicidades a ustedes también. At this time, can I please have all of our teachers present today please stand and be recognized? The teachers of our special purpose campus are truly passionate, genuine, generous, and caring with our students. Teachers, our students' success is your success. Thank you again. Next, I will take this time to introduce and welcome pillars of our community and the PSJA school districts, our school board members. Mr. Guadalupe Rodriguez, President. Mr. Ben Garza, Jr., Vice President. Mr. Jesse Vela, Jr., Secretary Treasurer. Mr. Humberto Bobby Rodriguez, Assistant Secretary Treasurer. Mr. Ronnie Cantu, Member. Mr. Reynaldo Gonzalez, Member. And Mr. Victor Perez, Member. Also, I'd like to take this time and recognize our senior staff present here tonight. We have Dr. Narciso Garcia, Mr. Juan Alvarez, Mr. Rene Campos, Assistant Superintendent for Support Services, Dr. Leticia Peña, Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction, Dr. Nora Cantu, Administrator for High Schools, Ms. Nora Rivas Garza, Administrator for High Schools, and Mr. Orlando Noyola, Administrator for Student Services. At this time, we will present our colors. If everyone can please rise and remain standing for the presentation of our colors and invocation. Post colors. The PSJ Early College Army JROTC Color Guard is presenting colors today. The members of the color guards are Right Guard Cadet Private First Class Dawson Carlin, U.S. Flag Color Guard Commander Cadet Sergeant First Class Arturo de la Cerda, Texas Flag Cadet Commander Sergeant Major Antonio Ruiz, Left Guard Cadet Private First Class Ryan Hernandez. The PSJA High School Army JRTC Mighty Bear Battalion is led by Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Jeremiah Garcia, Cadet Commander Sergeant Major Antonio Ruiz and is under the direction of Major Thomas W. Oaks and Sergeant First Class Nigel Rollins. At this time, we will have a student, Bruno Munoz, from College, Career, and Technology with the invocation.
First of all, I just want to say thank you for being here, for your family members, and for supporting us. Okay, dear family and friends, we are gathered together on this very special moment, the moment, that day where you're going to see your son, daughter, brother, sister, or friend graduate. This is the day we've been waiting for. This is the battle we've been fighting. This is the light at the end of the tunnel. This is the chapter that marks a new beginning in our lives. This is our graduation day. On behalf of all the graduating students, I want to give a very special thanks to all the Special Purpose High School and PSJA to make our graduation a reality. Now bow with me. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the wonderful things you do for us. Most importantly, we thank you for giving us a second chance in life. Oh Lord, thank you for blessing us with the knowledge, wisdom, honor, and loyalty that is required to go on in life. God, please bless those who never lost faith and hope in us. Dear Father, thank you for blessing every school, student, teacher, and staff member. We also want to give a special thanks to all the PSJA schools and staff and clean and cook for us in order for us to continue our education. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray, amen.
Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance. We have a student, Maria Isabel Alaniz, from Sonia Sotomayor Early College High School.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for a moment of silence. Thank you.
Thank you. Y'all may be seated. At this time, we will hear from our special keynote speaker. Dr. Norma Solais has over 35 years of education experience working with students, parents, educators, and community leaders. She received her bachelor's of science degree from Texas Women's University, her master's in education at the University of Pan American, and her doctorate at the University of Texas in Austin. Dr. Solais' educational work experience includes 23 years of serving as a high school teacher, high school administrator, and career and technology director with the Edinburgh School District. Her experience includes 7 years as LaVia's ISD superintendent. She has also worked at the University of Texas at Pan American as a college lecturer for 5 years and field supervisor for 2. Dr. Solais is the founder of Creative Leader Entrepreneurs, a leadership training business, and co-founder of the Treasures, Talents, and Tea, an antique shop, tea shop in Edinburgh community that also promotes the arts through creative classes. She calls these businesses her hobby and fun projects. Dr. Solais is currently serving her second year as a director of RGV LEAD Rio Grande Valley, linking economic and academic development, a regional nonprofit organization that facilitates collaboration between business, industry, and educational leaders of the Rio Grande Valley to open doors for students as they transition from high school to college and on their chosen career. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Norma Solais.
Thank you so much. I am so excited to be here this evening. This is actually the campus from where I graduated from 40 years ago. I was part of the class of 1976 when this campus was PSJA High School, Bear Country. So I feel like I'm back home. I have to tell you that I feel blessed that I received a wonderful education from the PSJ School District. I credit this school district for giving me the foundation I needed to be able to be successful in life. I cannot thank this district enough. They listed a few accomplishments of things that I have done, and I promise you I could not have done everything I've done without a good public school education, and PSJ did that for me, so thank you. I have to tell you that we are here to recognize the outstanding accomplishment of our graduates tonight. And I know for a fact that the school board, the staff of PSJA, your parents, families, and friends are very, very proud of you. We commend you for the courage and the commitment that our graduates have to be able to accomplish what they have today. You have fulfilled the requirements of your high school requirements and are receiving a diploma today, and we're so proud of you. So when I was asked to provide the commencement speech tonight, at first I thought, well, what can I possibly say that these students haven't heard already? And I actually stopped and thought about what I would have liked to have heard 40 years ago. A few tips of what might have helped me be successful. And obviously somebody shared those with me throughout my life because, in my opinion, I have had a good life. So I'm going to spend a little bit of time, just a few minutes, less than 10 minutes, because I know you're ready to get your diploma. But I'm going to spend a few minutes providing a few tips or a little bit of advice of things that might help you as you move on forward with your life. You're currently at a crossroad in your life. There's paths in front of you right now that you're going to have to make some critical decisions, and those decisions are going to impact the rest of your life. So as I start to give you just a little bit of advice, I'm going to ask one question that I want you to think about. Will you be able to support yourself and your family, if you choose to have one, for the next 50 to 60 years with the skills that you have today? Will you be able to support yourself and your family with the skills and the knowledge that you have today? I want you to think about that. Some of you may already know the answer. Some of you may not be sure. But one thing that I am going to recommend, that if you're not sure, if you said no, then my first piece of advice is that you need to continue your education. Because the more education that you have, the more employment opportunities you're going to have. And that is going to lead to more choices and more freedom. You'll have the choice of where to work and where to live. The more education you have, what you have accomplished to do today, you have your high school diploma. That has opened some doors for you. What you need to do now is ensure that you have as many doors open to you as possible. And that will happen with more education. So continue your education, whether it's a certification program, a 2-year associate's degree, a 4-year, or a master's or bachelor or a doctorate, whatever it may be that you choose to do, pursue that education. Second advice, follow your passion. Pursue a career in an area that you are interested in. Make sure you like what you're studying, like what you're working in. Because if you like what you're doing, work doesn't feel like work. It feels like fun. Make sure you pursue your interest. Make sure you like what you do. My third piece of advice is, once you're in the workforce, once you get that job, be the best employee you can possibly be. Don't burn any bridges. Yes, occasionally you have to work with a few people you don't like, but just deal with it. Learn to work as a team. Be the best employee you can be. And get to know as many people as you can know, because they will help you with your next job. And guess what? A lot of the people that you get to work with will be your lifelong friends. They are the people that you will become your strong friends in the future and will be with you till the end of your life. So value that. It's important. My last piece of advice is to value your family. You're here today because you have a support system sitting out there. Of family, friends, people who care about you, who have supported you. As you move on with your life, do not forget that. They are the most important things in your life. And at the end of your life, what you're really going to remember and people you're going to want to be around are your family members. So make sure that you take time every single day to thank them. Parents, congratulations. You have helped your child succeed in the first major step in their life. So congratulations, parents. And in conclusion, graduates, I'm going to let you know that you need to take advantage of the opportunities that will come knocking. But don't wait around for that knock on the door. You need to create those opportunities. You need to create the opportunities that will improve your life. You are the sole person in charge and in control of your own life. The decisions you make from now on are going to determine if you're successful or not. Take advantage of the first opportunity that you have now, and that's your high school diploma. Continue your education. Be ready for the workforce. Pursue your passion, and do not forget family and friends along the way. I wish you all the luck in the world. We are so proud of you, and we know you're going to be successful in life. Thank you so much.
Dr. Solais, we have this plaque as a token of our appreciation for speaking to us.
Thank you so much.
I'm going to take this time and introduce to parents and staff present the people behind the work that gets done at the campuses. And we'll begin with CCTA, the principals first. Absent is Ms. Larissa Mancha, from Elvis J. Ballou. Principal from Sonia Sotomayor Early College High School, Ms. Rosa Riquet. And myself, Darcia Cuellar from College, Career, and Technology, Early College Academy. Our assistant principals for CCTA is Mr. Javier J. Sainz. We also have present here from Elvis J. Ballou, assistant principal, Mr. Miguel Salinas. Ms. Consuelo Chapa, assistant principal at J. Ballou. And counselor present, Ms. Karen Cervantes. Sonia Sotomayor, assistant principal, we have Jessica Faye Villanueva. I'm sorry, we forgot. And we also have Ms. Mary C. Rodriguez, College, Career, and Technology Counselor. Thank you. Next, for superintendent's address and also for the certification of candidates, we have our very own, please help me welcome PSJA's ISD, Dr. Daniel King, Superintendent of Schools.
Thank you, Ms. Cuellar. What an exciting evening, right? Students, congratulations. Padres, felicidades. Congratulations to all the parents, to the teachers, for the results of your work is right here. And of course, students of yours. Just want to say a few words before I certify the graduates. And like I said, congratulations, students. And one of the things that I think that all of us learn, and that that I think that most of you have learned, is that life is not always easy. There's challenges, there's barriers, there's obstacles, there's things that happen in life that it's important that we always face those, keep on going, and if we don't succeed at something the first time, then try again, or try a different way, but keep on going. I want to congratulate you for the goal that you're achieving tonight, but I want to encourage you to keep on going. Keep on going to school. We live in a world where education is very important. We live in a world where you need, like Dr. Solais, your speaker mentioned, you need special skills and certifications and things like that to get the jobs that pay well. You need to be develop an expertise in something. So I hope, number one, I hope the end by the, after this week that you enjoy a really good holiday time with your family. It's a little extra special, right? Graduation and Christmas and New Year's and all of that at the same time, right? So a little bit extra special holiday. So enjoy that time with your family. But I would also encourage you then after the New Year, come back by and visit with your principals at your schools if you haven't done so already, and make sure all your paperwork is in order so you can get right on into South Texas College or Texas State Technical College or UTRGV or wherever it is you want to go to keep on studying and prepare yourself to be, to have that expertise, to really be ready to step forward. So I encourage you not to give up and to keep on. You've already proven what you can do, and keep on going and take the next step. Padres y familia, de vuelta felicidades. Muchas gracias para todo su apoyo, animando a sus hijos e hijas, ayudándoles, dándoles consejos, teniendo paciencia. Y les ruego que siguen apoyándoles y que siguen animándoles. Es muy importante que siguen con su educación. Aunque unos, como siempre, nosotros en la vida todos batallamos a veces, todos buscamos manera de llegar a la meta. A veces, para todos, pasamos por circunstancias que no están fáciles. La importancia es que tenemos que seguir batallando y seguir tratando y buscando manera de tener éxito en la vida. Tengo mucho orgullo, mucha admiración para esos jóvenes y para el trabajo que han hecho. Es importante que sigan con la escuela. Los directores están aquí después que las festividades, ¿verdad?, de Navidad, del Año Nuevo. Que vengan para atrás con sus directores, con sus consejeros para buscar ayuda, para seguir con su educación. Que siguen en cualquier institución que puedan avanzar, como South Texas College, Texas State Technical College, la universidad ahí en Edimburgo, pero que siguen adelante con sus estudios. Es muy, muy importante. Y aquí estamos para servirles. I want to thank our Board of Trustees for all of their leadership and support in having these opportunities for students and in all the different programs that we have. At this time then, members of the Board of Trustees, family members, guests, I hereby certify, based on the information provided by the principals, that these students who will be crossing the stage tonight have completed all of the requirements set forth by the State of Texas and by the Board of Trustees of the Far San Juan Alamo Independent School District, and have earned the right to receive their diplomas and be known as graduates of their respective high schools. Miembros de la mesa directiva, padres de familia, amigos, basado en la información que me han dado los directores de estas escuelas preparatorias, yo certifico que todos estos jóvenes que van a estar cruzando aquí enfrente en esta noche han cumplido con todos los requisitos puestos por el Estado de Texas y la mesa directiva del sistema escolar de Far San Juan Alamo, y merecen recibir sus diplomas y ser conocidos como graduantes del sistema escolar de Far San Juan Alamo. Will you please give them a big hand? Ms. Quay, you may proceed.
Thank you. Graduates, at this time, please stand. Graduates, please stand. You may now move your tassels from the right to the left. Congratulations. awarding the diplomas. Ready for the awarding of diplomas? Liliana Aguilar. Jesus De Leon. Anthony Rogue De La Rosa. Saul Delgadillo. Denise Denae Diaz. Jacob Garcia. Leopoldo Rafael Gloria. Felicia Ann Lopez. Selena Lopez. Jennifer Jarelli Lozano. María de Jesús Martínez. Jaime Uriel Mendoza. Melissa Lizette Moreno. Bruno Jesús Muñoz. Moses Nolasco. Melissa Marie Palomo. Anissa Jo Puente. Daisa Yvette Renteria.
Lynn Anthony Rodriguez. Alfredo Torres. Krista Nicole Vallejo. Aaron Vargas. Antonio Arturo Verduzco. Elizabeth Leija.
Now for the graduates from Elvis J. Ballou Early College High School. Pablo Cavazos. Jonathan Chavez. Brittany Escobedo. Matthew Fonseca. William Galicia. Carlos Gonzalez. Jessica Gonzalez. Charles McKissick. Fernando Mendez Cruz. Adrian Morales. Gabriel Narvaez. Brian Salas.
Good evening. Graduates for Sonia M. Sotomayor Early College High School are Maria Isabel Alaniz. Sandra Karina Hernandez. Noemí Martínez. and Roxanne Rivera. Congratulations, graduates.
Graduates, I commend you most highly for your spirit of resilience and persistence on your road to school graduation. While others have chosen an easier road, you have chosen to dedicate time and work that will make a better life for yourself. A high school diploma will bring you new opportunities. A high school diploma will tear down the obstacles that once hindered you from moving forward. So graduates, now that you have overcome the obstacles, the question remains, will you continue on this road to greater success? What is next for you? Take the time, write out your goals for the next 6 months, write out goals for the next year. And then, graduates, get up, go work, and reach your goals. Finally, to conclude today's ceremony, we have Jessica Gonzalez, student from Elvis Ballou, for the benediction.
Hi, Mom.
Okay.
I see. Please stand. Dear Lord, today we close an important chapter in our lives, but as in every book, we have to keep on reading until we reach the end. However, this is not the end. It is only the beginning of the next phase, which is to continue our education and graduate from college. We want to thank our principals, teachers, and family for supporting us through school and for encouraging us to never give up and always try our best. May God guide and protect the class of 2015 and continue to bless us throughout our lives. Amen.
This concludes tonight's ceremony. Thank you.